fingers. As opposed to parametric levers in articulation mobilizations. I will try to focus a target here by finding different vectors towards the dysfunctional area. We'll call this area SD, somatic dysfunction. The idea is once all these directions be defined into a unique tissue density direction to get a little sphere, very short, where the applicator will feel stillness as opposed to one direction in rotation, one direction in side bending, one direction in flexion, and a unique direction going through a barrier. This is the application of positional manipulation. This is an application for density levers manipulation. You find a still point and throw cinetic energy, bouncing back all the forces and restoring movement, as opposed to get through a barrier and into nociception to restore movement. The demonstration of a thrust on the segment C23 on the left-hand side using notions of compressions and density levers, as opposed to using a notion of a positional dimension going through a barrier. Okay, so my applicator, MP2, transverse process, articular process of C2, support suboccipital, opposite suboccipital, opposite part of the cranium, with a large hand underneath the muscles, the neck muscles. Okay, trying to look for density into the somatic dysfunction of C23 by closing the side bending here, rotating, side shift, flexion, counter rotation to zero against my applicator. Okay, and then I'm waiting for that little steel bulb as opposed to a barrier. And the bulb is coming, just a little bit of pressure from my tummy, very small. Okay, looking for a direction. My thrust will come from my support. Okay, and look at my shoulders here.